We understand that the ministry has successfully managed to bring up the testing capacity to 20,635 tests per day. May we know the average utilization rate of these testing facilities for the past few weeks? Also, given this high level of testing capacity, and we can see that there's less areas under EMCO, under enhanced MCO, and also the fact that there's only 4 red zone areas left in the country. Is the ministry now considering to do mass testing in these red zone areas?
Thank you very much. If you look into our capacity of testing in our labs, at the moment, we have 45. Before was 44, and then there's one more hospital, IKN, came in, and then we have 45 labs we are able to test. The capacity at the moment is 26,673. And yesterday, we did 25,106 sample, and so 94%. What is more important is that we have the capacity to test. But if we want to test, we are using the opportunity in terms of our capacity of testing for our targeted approach, that is the targeted group. So we have identified 8 targeted groups. One is the tablig group, second is the TAFIS, third is in a PKPD and our clusters, and fourth is the PASA, and the fifth, we are looking into Warga Emas, and then the sixth, now we are looking into foreign workers, for example, so that is also our cluster group. 7, that's our pasar, for example, the market, so we are doing that as well. So, and the last is the healthcare workers, so we are also looking into our healthcare workers. So now, the test that the capacity that we have, we will focus into these areas, these 8 targeted group. So that is our focus, rather than to test everyone. But if you were to test everyone, the next question is, how often do you test? Because if you test everyone and then you isolate them, that's fine. But they are still exposed in the community and the virus is in the community. So that's the next question. How often do you want to test them? So instead of testing everyone, so we focus into our targeted group. And you have shown that, for example, in MCO 1, 2 and 3, we are using the same approach and shows results now. So we managed to flatten the curve and we have won the battle, but we have not won the war yet. So what is more important is that today, because of our new strategy, that is actually CMCO, we started in May 4th, and we hope that the new strategy, we need the public to come together with us and to take the necessary precautionary measures and follow our SOP. So if the public can comply with the SOP, then rest assured that we can actually bring down the R-naught further. So today, our R-naught from 3.55 before the MCO, and today is 0.3. So it's up to us now whether the R-naught can be brought down further or it will increase in time. So we are monitoring the daily cases and our compliance in terms of the social responsibility, social discipline, and social compliance to the SOP that has been given by the Ministry of Health.